Hello, dear student. I hope you all are doing good. I am Dr. Sanjay Pagar, Assistant Professor, Department of Geography. I welcome all of you in this online lecture on the behalf of Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samajas, KRT Arts, BH Commerce, and AM Science, that is KTHM College, Nasik. Dear student, today we are going to discuss SYBSC's submitted first paper GG231, that is Environmental Geography Part 1. We will start in this lecture the brief introduction of our syllabus. Dear student, you know that from this academic year 2020-21, Savitribai Phule Pune University has revised the syllabus of SYBSC Geography. Now we have choice-based credit system syllabus. The syllabus of SYBSC is been divided into two semesters, semester first and semester second. In first semester, we have three papers. The first two papers are theory paper, whereas paper three is practical paper. The title of our first theory paper is Environmental Geography Part 1. It consists two credits. The second theory paper is Geography of Maharashtra, the physical Part 1. It also consists two credits. And third paper, we have practical paper. The title of this paper is Surveying Part 1. It also consists two credits. Dear student, same paper we have in our second semester also. Among all these three papers, I will be teaching you all the first theory paper, that is Environmental Geography Part 1. So let us discuss the syllabus of our paper, that is Environmental Geography Part 1. In this paper, we have four major topics and many subtopic and learning points. The title of our first topic is Introduction to Environmental Geography. In this chapter, we have two subtopics, Introduction and Ecosystem. And also we have various learning points in first chapter. The first learning point, we have Introduction to Environmental Geography. In this learning point, we have also some sub-learning point. The first sub-learning point is meaning and definition of environmental geography. Here, we will discuss what do you mean by environmental geography. And we also discuss the various definitions that are given by various geographers and ecologists that we are going to discuss here. Then we have nature of environmental geography. The nature of environmental geography we will be discuss with help of some points. The points like the nature of environmental geography is a descriptive nature. It's a dynamic nature. It's a scientific nature. It is a applied nature. It's an interdisciplinary nature, and so on. With help of such points, we are going to discuss the nature of environmental geography. Then we have scope of environmental geography. The scope of environmental geography means what are the points, what are the topic that we are going to discuss in this subject, that we will discuss here. Then we have significance of environmental geography. The significance of environmental geography means how the knowledge of the subject is useful for a human being in his daily life or in various sector, that we are going to discuss here. Then third sub point is type of environment. There are two major type of environment. One is physical or natural environment, and second is man-made or the cultural environment. The environment which is created by nature itself is called physical environment. It consists all components that are provided by nature, and hence it is called natural environment. For example, mountains, plain, ocean, soil, forest, river, mineral, and so many things are the part of natural environment. Then we have a second type of environment is man-made or cultural environment. The environment that is created by man with help of natural environment is called man-made environment or the cultural environment. It includes culture, tradition, values, settlement, road, industry, and occupation like agriculture and so many are the part of man-made environment or the cultural environment. Then we have a very important sub-learning point, that is ecosystem. Ecosystem is a very important point of our subject. In this ecosystem, we have three sub-points. The first is definition and concept of ecosystem. Dear student, the first time the concept of ecosystem was introduced and explained by the British ecologist A.J. Tansley in 1935. After that, the various scholars and ecologists tried to define the term ecosystem that we are going to discuss here in this topic. The second point is structure and function of ecosystem. Here, structure of ecosystem we will discuss with help of biotic and abiotic factor. Ecosystem is interactions, interrelationship between biotic and abiotic factor that we are going to discuss here. Then we have a second subtopic here, that is function of ecosystem. The function of ecosystem we will discuss with help of food chain, trophic level, food web, and energy flow. With help of these sub points, we are going to discuss the detailed information about the ecosystem. Then third one is major type of ecosystem. There are several ecosystems on the Earth's surface. Generally, ecosystems of the Earth are classified into the two classes, namely terrestrial ecosystem and man-made ecosystem. Ecosystem on the land are called terrestrial ecosystem, whereas the ecosystem that are created by man with help of natural environment is called man-made ecosystem. And agriculture is an ideal example of man-made ecosystem, whereas equatorial ecosystem is an ideal example of terrestrial ecosystem. The ecosystem located within the water is called aquatic ecosystem, and river ecosystem is an ideal example of aquatic ecosystem. This is about our first chapter. Then we have second chapter, that is man and environment relationships. In this chapter, we have few subtopics. The first is the relationship between human life and environment in the different region. In this chapter, we have three learning points. The first, human life in mountain region, then human life in desert region, then we have human life in coastal region. Human life and occupation are not same everywhere on the Earth's surface. The human life is varies from region to region and place to place. The people living in different part of the world have different or the separate lifestyle. It means what we have a human life in the coastal region as per the local environment and the local resources, that type of the human life we don't have in desert region or in the mountain region. In each geographical region, we have specific human life. the construction of the houses, or the nature of occupations, and what the clothes that are wearing by human being at particular place are different. That we are going to discuss in this chapter. Then we have chapter 3, that is environmental problem. In this chapter, we also have two subtopics, that is global issue and India's major problem. The first learning point of this chapter is major global environmental issue causes an epic. The first is climate change. The climate change is a global environmental problem. Deal with global climate. The climate change is nothing but a major shift of an abnormal change in the climate pattern. The various human activities and also some natural processes are responsible for climate change. That we are going to discuss. What are the reasons for responsible for international levels climate change, and what are the effects of such climate change on human being and other organisms? That we are going to discuss in this topic. Then we have a second very important topic, stratospheric ozone depletion. You know that ozone layer is a very important layer with respect to the human life and the other living things that are present on the surface. The ozone layer is located at about 30 to 35 kilometer from the Earth's surface in the stratospheric layer. It is also known as the bulletproof jacket of the Earth because it protects all the life on the Earth's surface from the ultraviolet rays of the sun. But during last few years, it is observed that the amount of ozone layer in the stratosphere is decreasing rapidly due to various reasons that we are going to discuss here. What are the reasons that are responsible for depletion of ozone layer in stratospheric layer? That we are going to discuss. And also we will discuss what are the effects of such depletion of the ozone layer on the Earth's surface. That we are going to discuss here. Then we have a third very important topic, that is biodiversity depletion. So biodiversity is very important for ecological balance. Biodiversity means the biological diversity. But during few decades, it is also observed that at international level, the biodiversity is depleting very rapidly. That we are going to discuss here. What are the reasons? What are the causes that they are responsible for depletion of biodiversity at international level? And what are the effects of such depletion of the biodiversity at international level? That we are going to discuss here. Then we have a second learning point in the chapter is major environmental issues in India, causes and effect. The first is loss of biodiversity. In India also, we have very rich biodiversity spot such as Eastern Himalaya and Western Ghat. In this area also, we observe during last few years that there is a very rapidly loss of biodiversity. That we are going to discuss. What are the reasons again here? That we are going to discuss with example, that loss of biodiversity problem in India. Then we have a water pollution. The water pollution is also very important problem that we are facing in India. The water pollution is most important and a serious problem that we observe in India. Water gets polluted naturally as well as artificially due to various human activity. The rivers like the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Godavari, the Krishna, and so many rivers in India are getting polluted due to the various human activity. Even the water of this river is not suitable for drinking purpose also. So what are the reasons for such water pollution in India, and what are the impact of the water pollution we've observed in India? That we are going to discuss here with help of various examples. Then second important pollution is air pollution. The air pollution also a serious problem that we are observed in India. There are several sources of air pollution in India: industrialization, urbanization, transportation, agriculture operation, mining activity, and other various causes that are responsible for air pollution in India, that we are going to discuss here in this topic in detail. Then we also have a noise pollution and nuclear pollution, that is also called as atomic pollution. So here also we are going to discuss a detail about what is noise pollution and nuclear pollution, what are the causes of both pollution in India, that we are going to discuss here, and its impacts of noise pollution and nuclear pollution in India, that we are going to discuss here in this topic in detail. Then we have a last chapter, that is specific environmental issues in India. Here also we have some subtopic: the major environmental crisis in India and efforts to resolve this problem. And in learning points we have two major points. The first is energy crisis impact and remedial measures. So energy crisis is also very important and the burning problem that we are observed in India. There is a continuous demand for energy from various sectors in India, like agriculture, like industry, and even the domestic sector also demanding energy day by day in India. But in other hand, the government of India and the state government also not able to fulfill this need of human being or the people in India. There is a continuous rise in the prices of fuels and electricity. So the impact of such energy crisis we observe in various sectors in India, that we are going to discuss here, and what are the remedial measures that are adopted by the government, NGO, and even the individual level, that we are also going to discuss here in this topic. Second learning point is major environmental movement in India. In this learning point, we have also three sub points. The first is Western Ghat conservation, a contemporary issue. You know that Western Ghat is a very important region with respect to rich biodiversity. Western Ghat is a 1600 long mountain range that runs parallel to the western coast of India. It is also a very important biodiversity spot of Western India. But it is observed that during last few years there is a great loss of biodiversity in this region. The Mother of Godwill Committee submitted a report to the Government of India in August 2011. On the basis of the survey the committee conducted in this region, they observed that there is a great loss of biodiversity that mentioned in the report. So therefore, the local social worker, the farmer, the senior citizens came together and they started the movement to conserve the biodiversity or the biodiversity depletion of that area. So that we are going to discuss here, the nature of that Western Ghat conservation issue or the movement that is started by the local people, that we are going to discuss here. And second very important movement, that is CIPCO movement. It's a one of the ideal example for to stop the deforestation in India. The CIPCO movement was started in 1973 under the leadership of Mr. Sundarlal Bhavguna. It was started in for the main objective, that was to protect the trees from cutting process that was started by the local contractor of the forest. And this movement was success on a large scale because the state government stopped the cutting of the trees during that period. And then we have a last movement, that is Narmada Bachao Andolan. The Narmada Bachao Andolan is also very important movement in India. The Narmada is a very important river of India. The Narmada River is also known as lifeline of Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. The Narmada Bachao Andolan, the movement was started in 1985 under the leadership of Medha Patkar. It was the movement was against the construction of huge dam, that is Sardar Sarovar Dam on Narmada River. The main objective of this Andolan was to protect the right of tribal people and the local people that were affected by the construction of Sardar Sarovar project and the backwater of this dam. The backwater of this dam is spread on a large scale, on a large area of the catchment area of the Narmada River. And therefore, the local people, the tribal people and the local farmer affected due to this backwater. Therefore, this movement was started by the Medha Patkar with help of the local tribal people and the farmer. It was also a great success because the government of India stand for Narmada Bachao Andolan, and they also stopped the construction of dam for some period, and they solved the problem of these affected people. Therefore, this moment is also very important in the history of India. So, dear student, I hope then we have some reference books. So these are the reference books are very important for update your notes and to understand each and every topic of our syllabus. So dear student, I hope you will all have proper idea about our syllabus now. Still, if you have any problem related to this topic, then you can send your email to me, your mail to me on my email address, that is sanjaypagar@kthmcollege.ac.in. I repeat my email, sanjaypagar@kthmcollege.ac.in. So that's all for today. We will meet again in our next lecture. Still, goodbye. Thank you.